Good morning, Galaxy Heroes, and welcome to Geonosis Territory Battle. This is the second time that we've tried this. It comes up, we've got the option now of running this as opposed to either light or dark side Hoth territory battles. So this is the special, and you'll notice that one particular tune has been omitted this time, which is General Grievous. Why is General Grievous not here? Very simply because he does a better job of killing your droids than the clones do, believe it or not, because the clones are pretty good at this now. It's the coffee in the morning. So the Grievous, basically, because I've got, is it the second one? I can't even remember which one it is, but one of the Zetas basically kills all these droids. And we don't want that. So what you'll notice throughout this run is that my B1 is actually increasing in stacks, which is good, because B1 is the healer. I'm going to try spreading around. Okay, there are caveats to this. The first caveat is it really does depend who you meet along the way. Discussions or conversations having around this is that you're golden unless Shakti. Actually, I'll add either Shakti or Padawan Annie turn up. If they turn up, then at present, I don't know, maybe someone's beaten them. Plaudits to you if you have. We're plodding along. We're up into third phase. Let's get rid of this ARC trooper. Don't like them. Trying to eliminate the main threats. So the sharpshooters, the grenade throwers, and then the healer revivers. So the way that I've tried to approach this run is kill the damage dealers, then focus down on the healers, revivers. So into the final phase, and we got all the clones minus Shaq. Happy days. So now we've just got to see whether we can get through all these clones, because there are quite a few of them. But at the moment, we're all still pretty healthy. Everyone's still got protection. Sharpshooter's gone, yes. I've just got the other one to dispatch now. As you can see, I'm trying to get rid of. And then I think we're going to go for the one in red, because I believe the red one is the medic. No. Maybe that's not the medic then. Oh no, it's not, it's the commander. But always depends on who you encounter along your run, because it does seem to vary. But this squad looks pretty good without Grievous. Was that 243, is it? It's a tiny little image there for me to see. It looks like we've got, 246 stacks, 250 stacks, and a money shot. Yes! This is the one that I failed to complete first time round. So this one is the bugs one. with the bugs, we're running under a Poggle lead, and as we all are aware, Poggle is kind of like a day one toon with his abilities tuned to day one. So yeah, could really do with a rework, really do with a rework. Until that happens, we just gotta plod along. Would be nice though, as we're forced to run Poggle lead, it would be nice for the devs to kind of update, shall we say, his abilities along with the rest of them. Minus Brood. Brood's a new shiny, so yeah, we're happy with Brood to be as is. Because they are proving quite a useful faction outside of TB now. When I say outside of TB, I mean they're proving a useful faction in Grand Arena Championships. And also Territory Wars. Yorkie tried taking down a bug squad and burnt through like three squads, not even touching them. So you need a specific counter, I think, for bugs. Backwards and forwards there from the brute. So where are we now? We're into 3 of 4. Plodding along. Sunfac, I've boosted Brood and I've boosted Sunfac with gear 12 pieces. So Brood's got a lot more health, and as does my Sunfac now. However, the other three are squishy, especially under the Poggle lead, because they don't get the bonuses of Brood's health pool because he's not leading. And look, Padawan Anakin. So I'm panicking now. Look at that first move, and I lost three. So this really now is an uphill battle. Can we do it? Of course not. Darn it. Okay, so excuse me. I donated my Bastilla Shan, which meant that I was looking for a fifth member of my Sith Empire squad. I'm gonna narrow in on who it should be. I wanted to keep Sith Assassin to go in my Traitor squad, because my Traitors aren't as quick. I just thought that Traitor would benefit from that additional boost, but that would have been a great one for an additional shock. But so I'm in an R in, and I opted to go for another AoE with Death Trooper. I also quite thought, well, it's quite handy because Death Trooper will do two things here for me in this squad. One, he'll remove buffs, and we know how much clones love buffs. And two, once we've killed one of them, we can death mark with him as well. So yeah, I thought as a compromise, ideally you want Bastilla Shan, obviously. But yeah, we're into the final round. Everyone's still intact. Just going through, having a look, seeing what I'm facing. Oof. Did like that move and that move. Marauder getting some big hits in. My Marauder is still gear 12. I hope you noticed on there, but almost at the end. It's looking good. Money shot. Marauder for the win. Yay. Speaking of Treya, here she is. So, yeah, as I say, with five Sith ships with Sith Assassin. That's what I was attempting to say there. I'm running Treya. I'm transitioning, kind of, with my lead under the Yorkie account, but I have been running Treya an awful lot, including Arena and Treya Triumvirate are an absolutely awesome squad. I'm pleased that Treya's retained her viability, because she is she is a very long farm, because the only way that you can get her shards is by competing in the Heroic Sith. She's the reward at the end of it, and all the toons from the raids are great. I mean, yeah, you've got Han from... let's go back to the very beginning. You've got Mr. Beardy from the pit, you've got Han from the tank, and of course you've got Treya from the Heroic Sith, and eventually we'll be in a position where we've got Wat Tambor on farm from the Geo, and hopefully he will be as good as the previous three I mentioned. Sorry, I'm just filling in the spaces here. So, into round three. We're still just looking at clones and getting the pairings. Apparently, sharpshooters travel in pairs, because that's what I seem to have got each time round on here. Trying now to keep my Sith Trooper alive, because of course he's the main taunt. I mean, Sion will, but only with his only on toons that have his marker on them, and the name of the marker eludes me at present. So, trying to whittle them down. Yay. I do like the fact that speeded up, they all sound like Smurfs. So, into the final round. Not too bad a nasty lineup. Already had that with the Padawan Annie in the final round. My Sith Trooper is taking an absolute pounding here. In fact, I'm not going to leave it just to the... It's not just Sith Trooper, it's all of them are taking an absolute hammering. This is day one, so it's only going to get worse from here on. Sorry, I'm moving around. I was about to grab and slurp some coffee, but I will try and hold off. So we lost Trooper. Down to four of them, but those three of those four are the Triumvirate. Although I am starting to get a bit angsty here that Sith Assassin is yellow. We're trying to get her back up. Now she's up into the green. At least she was stealth, but now she's gone red again. Got the revive from Sion in the bank, so at least we've got Sion a second time. Down to the last man. cons was it? Done. Yes. Another 4 of 4. Okay. Yes. I don't know. I honestly do not know what the logic was behind this. Excuse me again. I did donate Mother Towson, which meant that I couldn't run the Plague Sisters. I think it was just the fact that I've got a Gear 13 Grievous and I really wanted to use. And it wasn't until the battle started that it dawned on me. I brain fart moment. I'm thinking, great, so the front three are stealthed. Zombies always taunting. Every time zombie dies, Grievous will get reset. Of course not. That's not how it works. Because zombie is not a separatist. I would need either a Sarge or Dooku to die to reset for Grievous to go again. But Sarge is pretty well. Well, actually, no. I need to sort out her mods. She's missing loads of. So she's not missing. She doesn't have 6Es yet. I'm on a 6E quest to improve the number of 6E mods I've got just for the. Well, not just. I mean. 6E are the best, obviously, just because they're the 6 entry level to tier 6 of mods. The next one down would be 5A. So yeah, just from all the additional stat boosts that you get, that's why I'm saying individual mods obviously may vary. Sound like I'm selling insurance now. But so from the outset, I'm like, oh, I've made a really big mistake here. The other thing was that I was told, yo, I can mess around with this because it's day one. We're covered. We're getting our 6 stars just through our GP. So it wasn't imperative that I push and try. Not that I wasn't trying to get maximum score from here. But it was just a play around. Yeah. How much longer we got? This is the last battle, I believe. The reason I'm asking is because I need to start getting ready for my morning or for my day. You get that sharpshooter. Go on. Get him. Sick him. Couldn't decide whether or not to just focus down and try and get rid of Zaris and just speed up the killing. Opted not to. So going after the Troons and then Troons? Yeah, going after the clones even before tackling the Jedi. Oh, excuse me. So yeah, he doesn't even hit as hard. So it's not a comp I would recommend. In hindsight, anyway. Spoiler alert. Come on. Get this clone gone. Yay. All right. So we're trying our damnedest to. Oh, almost. We had one in the red there. There we are. So, down to 2. Down to... premature. Down to 1. Into the final round. So they made it all the way through to there. And then we're greeted with Shark. So, my squad is about to experience the full Shaak Twat experience. Wow, I said experience in the same sentence twice. Well done, me. Yeah, I must admit, my heart dropped when I saw her there, because going back to the beginning, I think her and Padawan Annie are the two leads that you just, or the two tombs that you really do not want to see in the opposition, just because they absolutely wreck. And we're trying here, but not to be. That's my run. Thank you for watching.